Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Verily, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek His help. And we seek Allah's forgiveness from the evil of our souls and the consequences of our actions. Indeed, whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is none who can misguide him. And whoever he misguides, none can guide him back to the straight path. I bear witness and I testify that there is no deity that is worthy of our worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness and I testify that Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Qurashi al-Hashimi al-Arabi is his final messenger and his most perfect worshipper. As to what follows, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I want you to close your eyes for a second and remember, think about the latest sin that you have done, the latest act of disobedience, the latest act that made you feel guilty for doing that act. And ask yourself, how recent was this act? How long ago did I commit this act? And if we, all of us, are truthful in this response, there is not a single person sitting here today except that he or she will be able to think of something they have done today. In fact, in the last few hours. Brothers and sisters, the reality and the fact of the matter is that each and every one of us is a sinner. Is a sinner, disobedient sinner. We sin by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly. We sin by day and we sin by night. We sin with our hands and we sin with our feet. We sin with our tongues and we sin with our eyes. In fact, hardly a portion of a day goes by except that we do something that we should not do, or we fail to do something that we should have done. So much so, that many of us, and this is the worst of all of the things, many of us even fail to register the fact that we are committing a sin. The sin becomes a part of our life. It becomes a part of our habit. We do sins like we eat and drink. We do it as a part of our daily routine, not even registering that a sin has been committed. Some of the early scholars of Islam, some of the Sahaba, when they saw the status of the Tabi'un are the second generation of Islam. When one of the Sahaba, Anas ibn Malik, when he saw how the second generation had strayed from the first, he said, I see you committing sins. I see you committing sins that you consider to be less weighty than the hair on your head. You consider to be like a hair. If we had done the same sin in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we would have thought we were destroyed. If this is Anas ibn Malik talking about the second generation of Islam, let me ask you, what do you think Anas ibn Malik would say if he were to see us here today? What do you think he would say when the majority of us don't even pray five times a day? When the majority of us have our money somehow tainted with haram? When the majority of us are committing not just minor but major sins on a routine basis? What do you think he or those of his times, or even more so, what do you think the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have said? Brothers and sisters, one of the companions who lived a long age, when he saw the status of society around him, he said, I don't recognize anything of what you do as being of Islam except your prayers. And even that you are changing, he said. I don't recognize your lifestyles. I don't recognize your characters. I don't recognize your emotions. I don't recognize what you are doing and what you are avoiding as being a part of Islam, except for the prayers, he said. And that, even in our times, the prayer has been something that is almost abandoned by the majority of us. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is high time that we think about how we are living our lives, what we are doing in this life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. One of the famous companions, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala, and he said, the example of a believer with regards to his sins Pay attention to this example, it's beautiful. The example of a believer with regards to his sins is that he thinks that he is a person sitting under a large mountain. That's his sins. And he is scared the mountain will collapse and destroy him. The believer sees his sins like a mountain, and that mountain will destroy him. And he said the example of the munafiq, of the hypocrite, of the evil person, the example of the evil person with his sins is that he sees his sins like flies that buzz around his face. All that he has to do is move his hands and the flies will go away. So the munafiq trivializes the sins that he does, and he considers them to be like the flies. He just brushes and they will fly away. Whereas the believer aggrandizes the sins, sees the sins as being much bigger than they are. Now let me ask you a question. Who does more sins? The pious believer or the hypocrite? There is no doubt the hypocrite does more sins. The believer does far fewer sins. And yet the believer takes those small sins that he does and he considers it like a mountain. And the hypocrite, he does huge sins, massive sins, and he considers them to be trivial like flies. The question is, and I ask myself this question and I ask you as well, how do I view my sins and how do you view your sins? Do you view them like flies that you just have to brush them away, ignore them? When you think about them, you change the topic? You just ignore and blank out? Or do you view them like a mountain that you have to account for? And this will give you the character, that will give you the category you fall into. O Muslims, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us even against the minor sins. He said, the minor sins pile up like twigs, like small branches. And indeed, a pile of small branches can give a very strong fire. What happens when you have hundreds of twigs, hundreds and thousands of small branches? It will become a huge mound that will give you a huge fire. Each one of them you consider trivial. But when you add it and add it and add it and more, what happens? That is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, anytime Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks any person about these trivial sins, that city is destroyed. Anytime Allah asks you about these trivial sins, the sins you consider minor, you have no hope then, because if you're going to be accounted for all of the trivial sins, then you have no way you're going to save yourself from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What then is the solution? What is the way out? There must be an exit. This exit, this solution has been very clearly emphasized in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every single son of Adam is a sinner. Every single son of Adam is a sinner. You cannot be a human being except if you commit sins. If you didn't commit sins, you would be angels. If you did not commit sins, you would not be human anymore. You would become angels. It is the angels who do not commit sins. As for human beings, it is impossible for a human being to reach the level of perfection where he abandons sins. It's not possible. You are human, and humans are bound to err. To err is human. Indeed, it is true. That's exactly what the Prophet ﷺ said. Every single human being is a sinner. But then what? If we're all sinners, is that it? We're all going to be the same? No. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized, and the best of sinners. Aha, so there is a best. There is a good category. There is levels of sinners. Not all sinners are the same level. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best of them. We are all going to sin. There is a best category. The best of sinners are those who repent. Repentance. Tawbah. This is the solution. This is the exit. This is the means of cleansing the sins that we have committed.